Hello and welcome to Lacey Broadcast News for October 2023. I'm Eric Stroin.
And I'm Jackson Conlon. LBN is our flagship program here at WLTS, and today we'll be taking a look at what's going on around Lacey Township High School and the surrounding community.
Later on in the show, we'll check in on the competition cheer team and learn about more about a Hispanic Heritage art show.
We'll also hit the court with the Harlem Wizards and get a taste of Tom and Dee's Italian ice.
But first, I know how I like to start my day with a nice cup of coffee.
Well then, you're in luck. Our first segment on today's show is about our very own school coffee shop. Let's check it out.
Well, I get in the morning around 6. I start brewing coffees, fill up the cappuccino machines, set up cups, grab ice for iced coffee, do the half and half, set up the table outside, just make sure everything is ready to go for the morning. Throughout the day, 50, 60 kids, they come in and enjoy and grab a coffee, so that's about it.
Usually I get cookies or like an iced coffee, like hazelnut flavored.
Every day I get a French vanilla iced coffee for the past 2 years, 2 years that it's been open.
I usually get like something caramel, but today I went with a s'mores coffee and it was really good.
Last year we did vanilla pumpkin spice, which was two coffees mixed together, which was a big hit.
It's the highlight of my school day, which is funny because I love most of my classes, but just going to lunch and going to get my coffee every day is such a good feeling, and it always gets me through the second half.
Definitely keeps me like really energetic, especially since I have like a lot of after school activities that I do.
I like how you don't have to spend a lot of money for it, because cookies, drinks, all of it is usually just a dollar.
The hot chocolate is very good. I love it. It's always hot.
Desserts that we do share, cookies. Once in a while we'll have like donuts, brownies, stuff like that.
So usually that's my lunch, either a coffee or a cookie. And I always get it for my friends whenever they like don't have a lunch, I always get it for them.
I'll get a thing of coffee and I'll drink it and I'll wake up during the day.
I didn't run it for all these years. I've only started last year, so.
He is so nice. All the people in there are just really nice.
No, just come on over and enjoy a cup of coffee. Oh, and on your birthdays, you get a free cup.
Now that we have our coffee, let's take a trip to Hamilton for their Hispanic Heritage Art Gallery and Festival.
This is their annual showcase of Hispanic artists all around New Jersey and the surrounding areas. Hamilton is a very diverse place, and this festival brings every corner of the Hispanic community together in a celebration of this special month.
This was the first year that they decided to include an art gallery with actual art from artists. Last year, I think they had a poem gallery, but this year is the first year that we've included multiple artists from Mexico, origin from Mexico, and then different places from Hamilton to New York City to Chicago to people still in Mexico. I wish everyone just knew more about this, because it is just when you look around, it's just organizations that are just meant for helping people. It's like the Wellness Center is a very it's a very great place that helps out a lot of people, and I will introduce you to everyone else who I think has some good words.
What does Hispanic Heritage Month mean to you?
So Hispanic Heritage Month means the appreciation of the people towards our Hispanics and our contributions to this country. I think it's a way that we could show that we don't only just party or drink. I think it's a way to educate people and culturize them about our traditions and our culture and itself.
It means a celebration of cultures that come together and show what they stand for. Like for example, today I was in Atlantic City. They had a flag raising event for El Salvador, Honduras, and Mexico. And it was amazing to see a lot of people come together and celebrate independence, each of the countries.
I think it just means a freedom of culture. Like, I think growing up, I kind of denied the Hispanic part of myself, and now I don't. So I just see it as this freedom of, like, a love for my people, just trying to embrace that. Just love. Yeah.
It's a way, you know, to show the community, show the people, you know, the diverse that's America, you know, even though we don't get to see it every day.
Hispanic Heritage Month means culture, you know, means love, means art, you know. It's a reminder of our roots. Even though we're so far away from where we were born and raised, we still come back to that emotion, that feeling of home here.
I feel like there's a lot of places where we're from, like, it depends on, like, how much the other population supports you. So, like, I know there's a lot of places that are mostly Hispanic, like Vineland and Bridgeton, but there's places like Hamilton that, you know, it's the population is like a lot of Italians, a lot of different people, and it's hard to find acceptance some places. But I feel like in Hamilton, the place Convivir, they've been putting in a lot of effort, a lot of work to get them flags up, up on our downtown, and it means like us fighting for our fighting for equality still. It still feels like it, and like that's what Hispanic Heritage Month is. It's celebrating all of, right, this is what it all is right now, just celebrating everyone, doesn't matter where you're from, just celebrating our pride for our heritage while doing the best we can.
It means a lot to me as an artist, as a photographer, and especially as a person of color, because, you know, growing up, it's really hard to find representation if you're like a minority and stuff like that. And to be part of this, it means a lot. And I really hope that some kid in that little audience sees like all the, not just my pics, but like all the other artists' work, and gets inspired to do their own creative works. And I think that could change the world. It means a lot. It would be nice, you know.
We are hard workers. We have a lot of strengths. We have many talents. It means that we are very culturized. It means union, it means family, it means friendship, and it means unity.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was flippin' awesome. Speaking of flippin', let's flip into our competition cheer section. This video will welcome our Lacey cheerleaders preparing for their 2023-2024 competition season.
What does a typical practice look like?
I would say that a typical practice is obviously we warm up, we do jumps, and then we have a set of time where we warm up our stunts then and then work on all of our stunts that we've been working the week, like our hand-to-hands, our full arounds, and whatever's new that week.
What qualities make a good cheerleader?
I think a good cheerleader is someone who's energetic, has skill, can stunt, tumble, and all around works well in a team.
Being positive, staying motivated, and perseverance. How are you feeling about this season so far?
I'm really excited. Our team has a lot of potential, and I expect really great things this season.
I'm feeling excited. All the girls seem really motivated, and I feel like it's going to be a good season.
What's your favorite skill to do in cheer?
I really like switch up extensions.
Why?
I just think they're really satisfying when we hit them, and they all really look good as we do them in a group.
What's a cheer memory that you will always remember?
Probably winning first place on our cheer competition.
If you could describe the cheer team in one word, what would it be?
Amazing. to have a group of girls come together who never cheer together and work as hard as they do, that's why I think they're amazing.
One word that I would use to describe the team is determined. Everyone works really hard and we're all after the same goal.
What made you want to start coaching competitive cheer?
What made me really want to start coaching comp cheer was I was a competitive cheerleader myself, and now that I'm a retired cheerleader, now I can really show my expertise and coach you girls.
What is advice that you would give to other cheer coaches?
Advice that I would give to other cheer coaches is to know your athletes. There's a lot. You have to know their strengths, their weaknesses, and once you do that, then you become a successful team.
Hey, y'all. Bye.
Now that we've introduced our cheerleading season, let's switch sports and shoot some hoops with the Harlem Wizards.
You want to take your family on a fantastic basketball journey?
Hi, my name is Avery Hayes, and I'm the Interact president. The Interact Club is hosting the Wizards because it is a fundraising event to help with Interact scholarships. The game is November 2nd at 7 p.m. and doors open at 6 p.m. in the Lacey Township High School gym. Teachers and administrators of Lacey Township School District are playing against the Harlem Wizards.
All right, boys and girls, make sure you come on out to the world famous Harlem Wizard basketball game. If you've never been to a game before, it's gonna be a lot of action. It's gonna be some slam dunks, some music, some dancing, and you may get a chance to win some free stuff. I know you guys like free stuff. We love to give free stuff out to all of our friends in the crowd that are having lots of fun. So hopefully you guys come on out and have a great time. See you there.
That segment was a slam dunk.
We've had a long day so far. Let's cool down with some Tomadee's Italian ice.
Time to get an inside scoop of our town's favorite sweet treat.
Well, I don't know if it was actually, I don't know if I was inspired. Year after graduating, I started out one day a week working for, it used to be called JD's Italian Ice. And the second I passed, you know, I finished my training, the person who trained me quit. So I went from one day a week to 4 days a week. And then the other girl who was working for the company also quit. So immediately I was doing 7 days a week for the whole summer. And I loved it. I loved it right away. It was really good money. It was easy. You know, the lakes, there were both lakes open, and Lacey was, you know, just beginning to really expand. Tons of families, and I loved the job. And I worked there for 10 years at JD's, and I left temporarily to get a real job, if you call it. And I got a 3% raise my third year there, and I quit that day and decided I was gonna buy it. And I bought it, and then I changed it to Tomadee's Italian Ice. You guys, my customers, and I struggle sometimes to call them my customers because to me they're family. I realized the past, since COVID, maybe a little bit before that, but since COVID, I realized how much I need the interactions, how important it is to interact with you guys, with customers, with my friends, with like family to me. This is my 33rd year. Forget about the money, because money comes and goes. You spend it on bills. You waste it on silly stuff. But the customers and the memories, that those are what keep me going. The smiles. It's the best part of my job. It's really something I need at least 6 to 7 months a year. if I have a customer and they buy all the time and they're 10, 11, 9, however old, and they break their arm, that's a tough day. So if my truck is there when they get home from the emergency room at 9 or 10 o'clock at night because it might cheer them up, I don't think I'm doing anything special there. It's just a nice thing to do. Unfortunately, I've had a lot of kids that have developed cancer that were my customers. Bringing them ice during chemo, it's not really a nice thing to do. It's the right thing to do. The Muddy Pig was, I do Hebrew recreation, and there were these five girls who used to come up to the truck every arts and crafts day with pictures of ice and suggested names. And they come up all the time, and one day they came up with the Muddy Pig, which I thought was a really great, funny name. It's chocolate and bubblegum, not the best tasting ice, although it's very popular. And I said, if you can get 100 kids to buy the Muddy Pig by the end of the year, I'll name it. And they got like 100 kids within a couple of days to do it. 1978, I grew up in Ocean Gate, and my grandma and pop-up used to take me to the beach all the time. When an ice cream truck drove by, we would always go out and we would get something. And so we heard this truck going up the street one night, and we went outside. And I used to get this chocolate banana bomb pop. It was called the, I don't know what it was called, but it was on a stick. It was chocolate and banana. And I asked them for it. They said they didn't have it. But they said they would mix chocolate and banana for me, which they did. And my pop-up was with me, and he got root beer and vanilla. So years later, when I bought the business, I named the chocolate and banana 1978, because it was the first ice I got off the truck. And I named root beer and vanilla the pop-op because my pop-op was with me. So those are how the ices got named. And I have a couple other names too, like Tidal Flav Flavor Wave was a fundraiser by the PTA. For $4, you would get a large ice and you got to submit a name for this ice, whatever, Mare themed. And Tidal Flav Flavor Wave, I picked two winners because I didn't want to just pick one kid. I wanted to pick all the kids. I felt terrible that I had to pick one kid. Like, I didn't know I was in charge of picking the answer. I thought they'd pull it out of a hat. So I picked Tidal Flav Flavor Wave, and that's one of the named ices.
Thanks for chilling with us. That's going to wrap it up for Lacey Broadcast News. For Eric Stroyn and the whole LBN News team, I'm Jackson Conlon. Have a wonderful day. I got a name.